January 20th, 2008. This is when Breaking Bad released. All these years later, and it's just somehow managed to slip from my watch list. Well, until now. What's going on, guys? I know it's been a while, and I apologize for the delay in video uploads. I've been experiencing a nasty case of burnout, and quite a lot has changed for me since my last upload. But, to start off on some good news, we are a little under 100 subscribers away from my first 1,000, and with that, I got some pretty hefty shoes to fill. Between this video, and my 1K subscriber special I have planned, and hopefully working to get more of a regular upload schedule. But, aside from that, you guys are here to listen to me talk about some Breaking Bad. So, before I get started on my thoughts, a little bit of context and a wee bit of history to go with it. Between a few different anime, Star Wars, The Walking Dead, and mostly just life in general, this show always managed to slip through the cracks of my watch list. It didn't really help that this show was known as the "that show about drugs and drug dealers" for the longest time. Which didn't really help it any. Back then, I didn't really watch retrospectives or reviews on shows unless I had already seen it. I was admittedly pretty stingy. If I watched a new TV show, it was more than likely recommended to me by a good friend, or I saw an advertisement that was done really well and it just caught my eye. So I hadn't really seen the buzz around this show, or the near universal praise of Breaking Bad gets as being one of the best television shows on TV. Well, considering all the memes, all the iceberg lists, the factoids, the 101 facts, the tie-ins with The Walking Dead, and people just generally having a buzz about how damn good this show is, and, well, thanks to the internet, 14 years later, I'm finally sitting down and watching it. 5 seasons, or 62 episodes to be exact, to sit through. With Better Call Saul and El Camino to be on the table, as well if I really do happen to enjoy this show. But, without further ado, I want to get on with my thoughts on the show. This video is all about my thoughts after watching the very first episode of Breaking Bad. This show does a good job making the viewer feel the mediocrity of Walter White's life at this point. Walter is walked over throughout his first episode. His wife Skylar calls all the shots, nagging him multiple times throughout the episode about doing things her way. Something he doesn't fight back against in the slightest, which seems to be implied to be after years and years of this monotonous lifestyle that he's been living. He's spineless, or he lost his nerve over the years. He does work 2 thankless jobs, neither of which he is a standout in, which is a chemistry teacher and a car washer. And Bryan Cranston really nails the feeling to the audience that Walter White really feels like he's taken a sort of backseat in his own life. He hasn't really had any control over his destiny or his own choices, at least since he's been married. Walter has seemingly sacrificed his own agency and desires in order to provide for a family that has gotten used to not thanking him for his duty. And because of that sacrifice, he has seemingly lost his personality, so most people just view him as boring. They may respect him for going to work, but in terms of anything he'd want to do with his own life, or, you know, anything that he chooses to do on his own, he's forfeited that. Walter White is a glorified cog in the machine of the clock that is his family, and because it's been like that for so long, it's just routine. He goes to work, and he comes home, and he does it all again tomorrow. Walter White, at this point in his life, is essentially living what is a stereotypical American dream, or a stereotypical family man. He goes to work, he comes back, that's all his personality is, there's no time for anything else. But what does that really cost him in the long run? Well, we got a good example of what exactly it is that he lost. Cue up the scene from his 50th birthday party.
Clock 22, that's my daily carry, okay? I mean, unless you're talking, what, plus B plus loads. You can forget the 9 mil. If you're gonna bring a gun, baby, you gotta bring enough gun. 40 cal.
This is awesome right here.
Nice, isn't it?
Yeah. Dad, come check this out.
Yes, yes.
Come on, take it.
Check it out.
out, Walt.
Ooh. No, it's just heavy.
That's why they hire men. Jeez, it's not gonna bite you, all right? Looks like Keith Richards with a glass of warm milk, doesn't he?
Two things. One, we see that Walter doesn't really have the balls at this point in his life to tell Hank no when he's clearly not comfortable with the idea of him giving Walter Jr. a gun. Secondly, Hank straight up mocks Walter's masculinity because he doesn't seem to know the weight of a pistol.
It's just heavy.
That's why they hire men.
Keeping in mind, this is still Walter White's 50th birthday, not Hank's.
Walt, you got a brain the size of Wisconsin. We're not going to hold that against you. But your heart's in the right place, man. Your heart's in the right place. We love you, man. We love you. Everybody, to Walt, Nostrovia.
Nostrovia.
But you could chalk this up to Hank just being playful and just playing around. He takes the drink from Walter, even though it's his drink. And Walter shows us that, again, he doesn't tell Hank to not do that. And Hank doesn't exactly ask him either. Well, Hank is simply entertaining the guests here, and he does give Walter credit for having a big brain and also having a good heart in the right place. This is only after he mocks him twice and then undermines his masculinity, which speaks on a longer standing issue that has been present in this whole family.
Oh shit, turn on channel 3!
At which point we apprehended 3 individuals and placed them into custody. I'm proud to say the outstanding professionalism of my fellow agents at the substantial amount of methamphetamine being taken off the street.
Walter Hartwell White is a pushover, and his family, his entire family, has gotten used to that being the case. I'm saying all of this in order to highlight the stark contrast of Walter White before and after he gets news of his terminal lung cancer, where afterwards he gets a renewed pep in his step, and he doesn't really take shit from anyone.
I need you outside to do some wipe downs. Are you here to work or to be staring at the skies? Come on, let's go.
Fuck you, Bondo. I said fuck you! And your eyebrows! Wipe down this!
There are quite a few other scenes. There's one other scene where he beats up some bullies that are making fun of his disabled son, Walt Jr. And a scene I'm definitely not going to be showing, which is where he has sex with his wife, and his wife is completely caught off guard by his dominating personality in the bedroom. Once he is a completely different person once he gets this news of his lung cancer. Between this and the second revelation that meth actually makes you quite a lot of money pushes Walt towards cooking, especially since his knowledge about chemistry combos for what I consider to be the perfect recipe for disaster. His lung cancer gives him nothing to lose, and makes him feel more confident to do what he feels is necessary. And on top of that, he is able to be a notable person, and self-made man due to his renewed confidence. And chemistry allows him to make some damn good meth, according to Jesse and the other people that he shows the meth to, like Crazy 8. So, to recap. With him getting into the meth business, as well as his lung cancer revelation, he gets to combat his mediocre and lackluster life with this limited time he has left, and on top of that, he gets to feel more like a man, and he gets to feel like he's making his own money. He's like the self-made man, which is something he's never been able to do for at least the last 15 years. This surge of self-confidence and in an embroiled masculine sense gives him this understandable high, which I imagine this is likely going to be a recurring theme or some kind of recurring issue throughout the rest of the series going forward. I could be off base here, but these are some of the things I've noticed so far in this first episode. I really gotta hand it to Vince Gilligan for an introductory episode. It's shot and designed very well, in my opinion. I can already see why this show is so well received, and I can also see the workings of what I assume to be foreshadowing for the things to come. As of the making of this video, as I've stated at the beginning as well, this is only when I've watched the first episode, so I don't really know exactly the state of what the rest of the series has to offer, but I have sort of sense that while Walter might may or may not actually try the meth that he makes, he may very well get addicted to a different substance, which is his ego and his desire to be the man that everyone says he should have been, or that he should be. Maybe be more like his brother-in-law, Hank Schrader, who seems to be this beacon of masculinity and buoyancy and just a very fun guy to be around from the looks. I have a feeling Walter White's going to get an addiction to retaking the control in his life again and feeling like the man and this like power trip he's going to be going on. And this resurgence of confidence is going to aid that. And the device he's going to be using to get to that point is through the meth business and his knowledge of chemistry and cooking. Definitely not the most legal way of doing that, but more power to you, I guess, Walt. But there is kind of an elephant in the room that I haven't really mentioned, which is the fact that Hank, his brother-in-law, is a DEA agent, which means he's, well, constantly hunting down drugs, drug dealers, and drug makers. So, I think it's fair to say that Hank and him may have a crossroads to come to at some point, assuming they don't retroactively write him out of the story or something like that. But going off of how well written this first episode is, I have a feeling that's intentional that he's a DEA agent and that it won't be something that just goes away after a while. I have a good feeling that Hank is probably going to be, if not a quote-unquote villain, he's at least going to be an antagonist for Walter White in the near future, if not maybe later on. As of the first episode, I also have to give Vince Gilligan a lot of credit because there isn't really a character in this show that feels out of place or badly written. Skylar White feels like the kind of woman that has gotten used to the idea of her husband being very subservient and that she's taken the reins as the leader of the household. Walter White feels like the kind of guy that's been beaten down. Hank feels like the kind of guy who, you know, he's lived his whole life like this, like a Shane-type character from Walking Dead, if you know what I mean. Somebody who's very buoyant and outgoing. And even Walter Jr., he's, you know, he has not on screen for very much in the first episode, but, you know, he definitely comes across to me as a likable character, as well as Jesse Pinkman as well. My only fear with the show going forward is that these characters, character arcs, or plot points don't get repetitive or boring as the seasons go on, as these shows tend to be. But I am very optimistic as of the making of this video. I'm definitely going to be watching more of this show, and while I may not make a video about every episode, I'll definitely be making a video about every season as I make progress throughout the entire series going forward. While the internet may be a cesspool, I have to say, I hate to say it, but I don't think the internet may have been so wrong about this one. But we shall see as time goes on, and, you know, I watch more of the show. I am very optimistic about Walter White in the Breaking Bad series. And, well, to wrap things up, that's been a video. So, I'll see you all in the next one. Peace.
The DEA took all your money, your lab. You got nothing. Square one. But you know the business. And I know the chemistry. I'm thinking maybe you and I could partner up.